Hi everyone, this is Aki with another Pages video. We're going to go over such a simple task, but sometimes can be very complicated by as adding, removing, deleting, cutting, pasting pages. And it really depends on what kind of documents you have in your pages. There are two different ways of setting up your documents in Pages. You could have the word processing style of document or page layout document. And I'll go over each of them and different ways of adding and removing pages depending on what you have. The way to find out what's your setup, if you go to Pages and if you click on document at the very top, if you scroll down, if you have checked document body, that means that your document is set up as a standard word processing document. So you're just typing things, you know, what have you, like you're just typing and it's just a regular text processing document. Let's take this out. And then if you have this unchecked, that means you have a document that's set up as page layout. And you can't tell the difference necessarily right away. Page layout is more set up in these text boxes. Let me give you an example. So for example, you see this text here and it looks regular, but it's actually in a text box. So it's more like for brochures, flyers, and so on, kind of like what InDesign does. That's what this option is available in Pages. So let's go back to page in word processing and let's go through some of the options that we have in adding, removing, deleting, and pasting pages. First way of adding pages to a word processing document is basically keep writing. So let me just scroll down somewhere below here, and then if I, you know, I keep writing and writing and so on, and I just keep writing, that's how I got another page. And so that's the first one. Then another option is if you set up your cursor somewhere, if you go up to the menu and click add a page to this document, it will add a blank page. So now I have a blank page in between my pages. So you can see it, I have two blank pages now. Now, what about if I want to delete this page? If I select this and right click on it and say delete, it will actually delete, what will it delete? The whole section. So in word processing document, I'm going to undo, it's not so easy to delete just single page. What you can do is actually put your cursor somewhere that you want to delete this page and just click delete and go through just normal deletion process. And I was able to remove these two blank pages. So you can do that, but you can't just right click and delete this way because you're actually selecting the whole section. You see in the thumbnails that are showing on the left, the way to show your thumbnails, if you click on a view right there, you have an option to show your thumbnails or not. I don't know why it's not document. Oh, I see. If I click page thumbnails, I can see it. Now, because this, the way I have it set up in my document, I have facing pages. I'm able to see two pages at a time. And actually, I can change how I see it. So if I unclick the facing pages, now I will just have one page at a time showing because each of the page, the margins are the same. For facing pages under document setup, the margins are a little bit different. Inside margins might be different than outside margins. It's more like for book production, self-publishing, and so on. But if I click on that, I can also change the view size here. If I just grab, like kind of select the line in between when you have this kind of icon, like these arrows, and then use my trackpad to increase and decrease the size. I like to see the facing pages because I like to see all these sections and documents. And now you see I can increase it to make it larger. Now, whenever you see you click on a thumbnail, you see a section. So I know if I want to duplicate a section, I can right click and duplicate. But this duplicates the whole section, not just one page. So I'm going to undo this. Let's say if you want to be able to do that, I could create a page, like I have a single page here, and I can duplicate that. So then you would just add that one page. Now you can also just take the text that you have here and paste it somewhere else. I'm going to go to this empty space, an empty page, and I can just paste it manually this way. Now you can also go to another document. So I have another document here, sampler right there, and maybe I wanna copy or paste sections. I can actually select a section, copy here, copy, and go to my other page word processing document or my page layout document and go to the end, right click and say paste. And I pasted the whole section. So I didn't paste just the page as we talked about it in word processing layout. It's confusing because you have to, it's different from page layout. But in word processing where you set up your document, you're actually copying sections, not pages. Now, another tip that I can share with you is like when you're working with this word processing document and it's just hard to tell what's going on where the pages, like you see these sections, I actually like during the time when I'm working on a document is actually adding slight background so I can tell right away that this is a different section by itself. So if you select that section on the left and if you go to document section, you can just add a fill. Like obviously this is a very harsh color, so I will just add something very light and I'll change opacities just so I can tell they're different, like quickly just by looking at the thumbnails what's going on. Now whenever you find yourself that you have some text with background, I actually have a video on this. Now if you have your document set up as page layout, so I have these text boxes and stuff, actually each of the pages it's separate, but you could have a mixture of page layout as well as some text as a body text. And I can tell because I have this document body here, if I uncheck it and convert it all to page layout, it actually converts each of the page to page layout, and it's very easy to add and remove pages. You see each color of my thumbnails is a different page, and if I select that, you see it's just selecting one page at a time, not like in word processing when I had a whole section selected. So if I select this section and I want to add a page, I can click on the add page and it adds a page, but it's still going to be a separate item, and I can quickly remove it by selecting it and clicking delete. Or if I select the page and right click delete, I can do it as well. You can also very quickly, you know, move around the pages here. I can just grab it and move it, shift around how I liked. And actually, let me go back to word processing and show you the way to move pages here. You just grab, but you're grabbing section and you're moving a section. So you see in word processing, I am actually moving a whole section rather than pages. You would have to manually move like that text from that page somewhere else, versus in page layout, you can actually grab and move it. If I click document body, you don't lose the text boxes from page layout, but you have the option now to paste things or start typing as regular documents. So you can have a combination document, but again, if you're converting from word processing to page layout, you will lose anything that's not in text boxes. But if you have page layout in text boxes, if you convert to word processing, you don't lose the text boxes. So that's the difference. And you can have a hybrid, but the hybrid can only be if you're using the document body and create the text boxes. So hopefully this helped you figure out how to add, remove, cut and paste, and move pages around in Apple Pages. Thanks so much for watching.